guys. With the advent of Obamacare, the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services have put together what we call HCAHPS scores. These scores affect how a hospital is reimbursed by CMS. The scores are tabulated by a survey that is sent home with patients after their discharge and asks them to rate their quality of care. And something that is very interesting is these scores are public knowledge and they're put on a website so hospitals can be compared against each other and patients can basically online shop for their healthcare. Now, although healthcare is very serious and nursing is very serious, it is also considered a service industry. So in a lot of ways, we get lumped in together with hotels and restaurants and stores. I know a lot of you have gone to a restaurant. When you receive your receipt at the end of a meal, what does your waitress say? We have the survey here, please fill it out. And the same thing has happened in healthcare, where nurses and healthcare providers are asking patients, please rate your care. The sad reality and sort of the, sad joke amongst healthcare workers is that no matter where you go, the scores suck. The goal is to reach the 70th percentile on these surveys. And if you don't, then you actually will receive 30% less of your reimbursement from Medicare and Medicaid. And that equals millions of dollars a year for a healthcare system, which a lot of nurses say, well, we are not a hotel, we are not a restaurant, and people need to stop treating us this way. At the same time, we're held at a higher standard than hotels, so why not have patients rate their care with us? It's interesting because when you go to a restaurant, if a waitress is slow with your drink order, you're not going to feel personally offended at it. And I've noticed a lot of patients, when I as a nurse am late with their pain medication, they take that as a personal affront, that I am purposely doing that and putting them in a situation where they're going to be in pain. This has led to the nurse's job performance being based on their personality and how they come across their patients. I'm stressed out in another room with another situation, but I come into the room and I'm very hurried and my voice is kind of off and very short. And so the patient thinks either I don't want to be there or I'm angry with them. Honestly, this really frustrates me because there's so many times where I've worked so hard at my job and done the best job that I could and our score still sucked. The solution that I do know is that in general, we are not really good at communication. We still use medical jargon to explain to patients. We're still very hurried when it comes to our explanations to patients. And then we say, do you understand? And a patient feels like, well, if I say no, they'll think I'm stupid, or they'll get frustrated with me if they have to repeat themselves again. I know I would do that, so I would say, yes, I understand. And I just want to take this time to say to patients that might be receiving these surveys is that it's so crucial for you to fill out the surveys. I know there have been many times where I've had patients that have said, wow, you've given me such great care, and I'm pretty sure that they didn't fill out the survey. And I know that's the nature of the beast. If you have a terrible time, of course you are going to fill out a survey. You want to complain and make it known that you had a horrible experience at a restaurant, at a hotel, at a hospital. But it's really important that whenever you do have a good experience, that we can see the other side. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.